already know that 1. Gravity is the result of deformed spacetime. Matter tells spacetime how to deform, and the deformed spacetime tells matter how to move. And 2. Gravity is a pretty weak force. The strength of the effect decreases quickly the further away you go. So, if we have something massive, like a black hole or a neutron star, far away from the Earth, the influence of its gravitational field on the Earth is really tiny. This is kind of a good thing, because otherwise we would feel the gravitational pull of all sorts of astronomical objects all of the time. And we certainly don't want to end up falling into some big black hole. However, in terms of science, it means that it's difficult to measure these effects and learn more about the objects that caused them. But Einstein predicted that there is another way. His theory says that there is another method by which gravity is propagated through the universe, gravitational waves. Unlike the gravitational field, where the measurable effects drop very quickly, the effects of these waves will fall off much more slowly over distance. This means that we should be able to detect them. Normally, we would have to solve the calculations involved in Einstein's theory in order to understand. It says that for a system to emit gravitational waves, it only needs a non-zero third-time derivative of the quadrupole moment of its stress-energy tensor. Funnily enough, this is a bit complicated to intuitively understand, but instead of doing the maths, we'll just take a physical system as an example. Imagine two massive objects orbiting each other and only interacting gravitationally. This system could be two black holes or neutron stars, for example, although there are many other systems that would also emit gravitational waves. General relativity predicts that these objects cannot orbit around each other forever. This is because their accelerated motion turns energy stored in the orbits into gravitational waves that radiate energy away. The energy of these waves stretches and compresses spacetime perpendicular to the direction they travel. This means that the gravitational waves passing by will periodically change the distance between two objects in spacetime. For example, the distance between the Earth and the Sun, or you and me. But for almost all gravitational waves, this effect is really small. Imagine the radius of a hydrogen atom when you're looking at the distance between the Earth and the Sun. This is because astronomical objects are really far away, and the gravitational waves need to travel for a long time before they reach us. At the same time, the fabric of spacetime is incredibly stiff, making it difficult to make strong gravitational waves in the first place. Einstein believed it would be absolutely impossible to measure gravitational waves directly. But we are now reaching the point where we do have the technologies that can accurately measure such tiny effects. So, in addition to understanding the universe using the electromagnetic spectrum, we will also be able to observe it with gravitational wave detectors. This means we will not only see, but also hear the universe, therefore opening a whole new field of observational astrophysics. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see new videos as they are released. And if you want to find out even more, visit our website or find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+.